raise the money to actually build it. We do $100,000. So they've been raising a lot of money. Other materials and help us keep our way out. We're going to start building the foundation this morning, and we hope to have the entire school finished by the end of the month. The building will have three classrooms, one of which will be dedicated to preschool. It will have a library, a computer room, an office room, each trip we come down, we have six trips planned, and we bring about 6 to 8 students to each trip. So there's about 450 people that stay tuned to actually physically come in here to work. And there's another 450 that are United States raising money and bringing plans and innovations, helping us with logistics.
Is this something that you are always doing?
It's something that the students of the College of Engineering organize themselves. The Engineers Without Borders is a national organization that the university has formed chapter. When our students got together because they wanted to be able to do something with their permanent, which they have a very good engineering degree, they recognize that there are places that really have a major impact. And so they're reaching out. Debbie is a professor, and it makes me very proud that my students have done this. And they recognize how much of an impact they have. We're going to continue on and work on other projects around this climate. I think it's a credit to them, and it's a credit to the people of our community who are open and welcome.
Are you able to mention what those
other projects are? Right now, the village is prioritizing them. One of the ones we want to look at is helping improve the health center here, perhaps migrating into a building as well, and looking at water supply if they have enough, sufficient quality. And then there's some looking at the roads, trying to improve some of the roads. The village project committee will rank those for us after we finish this year.
This has
been the only one that we've been doing. There are 400 chapters in the United States, and they do a quality of enough of them to be able to send to America, to South East Asia. So there's a lot of students in the United States who enjoy doing this. Cleveland State has come to the names of this year.
May I ask, why is it that you select Wood Common to aspire specifically to the River Catholic School?
Well, the way that the project was selected was that it was put up as an Engineers Without Borders National. And we looked at it, and part of it is a language. It's the official language is English. So my students may know some Spanish, but it's very helpful with that. And it's closer, so more costly. We wanted to be able to afford to get the students here because that's not inexpensive. It's actually more expensive to find out. And the further you go, the more that costs. And that means less money to actually put into your project. So we chose Belize because it's closer than the other places. And it has the language to operate in the kind of technical.
Thank you very much.